No, I'm not asking for the amendments. In 2020, Pastor Apollo Quiboloy is the stockholder, one of the stockholders, right? Yes or no?
Yes, Mr.
Okay, so, and then after 2021, that is 2021, 2022, and up to present, wala na siya doon. Tama?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So, nakalagay na lang doon, Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. Tama?
The above, the name above every name incorporated, Mr. Chair. Yes, Mr. Chair.
As a stockholder, ito yung Executive Pastor of the Kingdom, and you have named that to be Marlon Acobo,
yes,
right?
Yes, Mr. Chair. 53.46%.
Nung 2020 po, how many percent yung share ni Pastor Quiboloy?
We will provide a copy, maybe, Mr. Chair, next meeting, Mr. Chair, because we have no record yet in our possession, Mr. Chair.
So, in your report kasi, Mr. Chair, meron siyang amount na, 750,000. So, si Quiboloy, tama po ba? Doon sa report na sinubmit.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so at ilang porsyento po yun ng buong stocks?
Buong stocks. So our record is not, we are not in the possession of the record, Mr. Chair. Our record is only 2023 and 2022, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so may
so
ask...
So we cannot confirm that, Mr. Chair.
So Mr. Chair, may I ask the record of 2020 to be submitted here, the list of stockholders...
Yes,
and their and their shares?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair. So, etong si Marlon Acobo have 53.46% share. Tama po?
No, it's not Marlon Acobo, but the Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, the name above every name, INC.
Well, and sabi... Wait. Mr. Chair... Sabi mo kanina, itong Marlon Acobo, you are referring it to Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. Niname mo na yon. So, nakakalito kasi Attorney Mark, yung sinasabi mo kasi, niname mo na eh, sino itong Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, Marlon Acobo. Ang share niya po ay 53.46.
But per GIS, the name, the owner of the 53.46 is the Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, the name above everything.
Who is that?
So, it's Marlon Acobo, Mr. Chair.
Yun na. Pinagloloko mo kami, attorney, ha? Huwag ganyan. Mapipikon na ako. Okay, so yun na nga yun. So, individual po itong tinatawag ninyong Executive Pastor... Individual po ito.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Hindi siya organization.
It is a soul. Corporation soul, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Soul corporation, sabi mo kanina, individual. Soul corporation.
Because it is registered under SEC. The Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ is registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission.
Is this a corporation of one?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Who is that person?
Marlon Acobo, Mr. Chair.
Yun.
Sole okay. Proprietor. Sole corporation.
No. It's sole.
Corporation of one.
Ha? Huh?
Corporation sole.
Corporation.
Pero corporation of one. Sa tao lang.
Ah, kaya nga. Sole proprietor.
So, it's not a sole proprietor.
Sa ano siya? Corporation
because
of one.
Because corporation sole, it is registered under SEC. Sole proprietorship is registered under DTI. That's different.
Ah, okay. Sige. Pag sinabi po natin sole corporation, isa lang.
One
corporation of one.
Yes.
Ah.
There's only one stockholder, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so yun. So how is he related to Pastor Quiboloy?
He is the Brother Marilyn Acobo is the executive pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ.
As per what date?
As of 2022, December. And Pastor Apollo Sikibuloy is the pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ.
Sir Chair, maybe we can ask the submission of the
document.
Mga documents.
Yes, we will submit
and we'll ask also, Mr. Chair, can we invite Marlon Acobo here in our next meeting, Mr. Chair?
Okay.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, thank you po.
But he is in Dubai now, so we can we ask for maybe 2 weeks or 1 week
okay.
from now?
We take yeah.
Thank okay. you. Sige. You said at present, Kibuloy is the honorary chairman of SMNI, right? Kasi sinabi mo kanina.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So as an honorary chairman, ano po yung role niya sa SMNI?
It's just a symbolic, Mr. Chair.
Okay.
Symbolic chairman.
So wala siyang control.
No function,
no control.
No day-to-day decision of the corporation.
Okay. And sinabi mo rin kanina, Mr. Chair, that Kibuloy is a black timer din.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yeah.
In fact, I can present, Mr. Chair, right now, a receipt that the Kingdom of Jesus Christ is a black timer of SMNI.
So are you aware of the case that Pastor Kibuloy is in the at in fact he is considered as the FBI most wanted FBI for serious crimes. Are you aware? The SMNI, are you aware po?
Per news, yes, I'm aware, but I have no personal knowledge.
Who has a personal knowledge?
I am not the lawyer of Pastor Apollo Sikibuloy with respect to that case.
So, hindi mo alam yung kaso?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
How about President Marlon Roset? Do you know the case of Pastor Kibuloy?
You can read it anywhere. You can read it in the news.
Hindi yan yung sagot na tinatanong ko. Do you know the case of, huwag ako yung tanungin mo,
yes,
Mr.
Honor.
Marlon Rosete.
Yes, Your Honor.
Ang tanong ko, are you aware of this case ni Marlo, yes. ni Kibuloy?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. How about Attorney Rolex Silpik? Attorney Rolex, hindi ko mabasa.
Well, Your Honor, I read about
yes
it.
Yes or no? Are you aware po? Yes or no?
Well, I read about it, so yes.
Okay.
But I'm not
so
a lawyer there. I don't even know.
So hindi ko po tinatanong kung kayo po yung lawyer. Tinatanong ko lang po.
Okay.
So ito po yung fact, no? So the string of charges filed against them, including Kibuloy, by prosecutors in Los Angeles, California, include conspiracy to engage in sex trafficking by force, fraud and coercion, sex trafficking of children, marriage, fraud and misuse of visas, bulk cash smuggling, promotional money laundering, concealment money laundering, and international promotional money laundering. So yun po yung case, okay, na final sa kanya doon sa Los Angeles. So with this, Mr. Chair, maybe in the next meeting, I would like to we would like to invite the DOJ and the DFA as regards dito sa case. Kasi alam natin ang SMNI, dati sinasabi nila ang major stockholder nito ay, o dati rin stockholder ay si Kibuloy, na may kinalaman din ito doon sa franchise. Or may kinalaman ito sa ownership, Mr. Chair. So can we invite the DOJ and the DFA so that we can know the status of the case? Okay.
So we will invite
Pastor Kibuloy.
Thank you.
DOJ and DFA.
Yes, we will do that. Thank you.
Okay. Kanina, Mr. Chair, sa SMNI pa rin, Mr. Celis mentioned that he discussed with SMNI's editorial board. So, ang ibig sabihin, sa anuman pong pinapakita nila o pinapa nilalabas nila doon sa program nila, ay alam po ito ng editorial board. Kasi sinabi kanina ni Mr. Celis na, na kinoconsult niya daw yung editorial board. Tama po ba yun? Sino po ba yung editorial board dito, Mr. Chair?
Wala po dito, Your Honor.
Kasi yun ang sinabi kanina ni Mr. Celis. Celis mentioned that he discussed with SMNI editorial board yung sinabi niya kanina no, na information. So that implies alam ng SMNI yung content ng program. Tama po ba?
After po nung nangyari po.
After. Po okay. Ay, after na rin nangyari, sa kinonsult yung editorial board.
Doon po namin nalaman. Kasi hindi nga po Your Honor makontrol. Kasi hindi namin masabihan kung anong itanong, anong sabihin, kasi nasa live na po sila.
Hindi, ano yung sinasabi kanina ni Mr. Celis na nagko-consult siya? It is before the program or after po?
Actually, Mr. Chair, the board knows...
Well, attorney, sandali lang po. Kasi... We can go back to the video. Whatever you say now, the video was very clear. And my understanding was, nakuha yung source, pumunta siya sa board, mm-hmm. tapos bumalik siya sa sa programa. So anyway, we will go, we will revisit na lang. Let's revisit the video kung sinagot ni Eric, okay? Okay, I will just revisit it. Kasi if he deny it now, it was said already, and she's quoting something that was said earlier. So we will just revisit the video. And that will be the basis for whatever decision we come up with. Thank you.
So, sinabi ko lang, Mr. Chair, so wala kayong alam sa content ng programa nitong laban kasama ng bayan? Wala kayong alam?
Noong time na yun, Mr. Chair, wala kayong alam po.
Okay, thank you.
I know sa ibang mga time. Kasi 3 years yan eh, because, na nag-i-air eh.
As a rule kasi po, we know the general content of the program, but there's no specific content.
Yes, you know the general content.
Yes, yun lang po ang okay. Alam po namin.
Okay. So wala po kayong editorial board dyan na mga kaalam. Re-reviewin na lang natin.
Sa ngayon po.
So ano po ba yung process ninyo? As a co-product, sabi mo kanina, Attorney Mark, etong programa na ito is a co-produced by the SMNI network itself.
When I say co-produced, Mr. Chair, with respect to the advertisements, 50% will go to the SMNI or to Swara Sub Media Corporation and 50% to the talents.
Ah, okay. Aside from
talent fees.
Okay. So, yun po pala ang ibig sabihin ng co-prod.
Yes, Mr. Yes,
okay.
Mr.
So, yung hatian doon sa mga advertisements.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So, thank you for that clarification. Dito sa KBP po, kanina malinaw na nasabi as attorney, Mr. Chair, kanina malinaw na nasabi po no na there is certain violation since they are not accredited broadcaster po ng KBP, yung dalawang anchor. Ano po ang saan po yung accountability mapupunta po? Since hindi naman hindi sila under niyo, di ba? So wala kayong hindi niyo sila mape-penalize or whatever the sanction. So sino po yung accountability just in case na lumabag ulit dun sa inyong code? Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair. The party accountable for violation of the rule of allowing only accredited KBP members to go on the air is upon the network.
So, meron po bang mga kaso na about the SMNI on the violation of code na nakasampa po sa KBP, Mr. Chair?
None, Your Honors.
So, wala pa. Okay. So sinasabi nyo kanina, Mr. Chair, ang KBP po, parang it seems that meron na violation do sa code na ang accountable dito po ay yung network. So, are you planning to, to investigate and to file whatever charge na related po dun sa inyong code?
Let me clarify your Mr. Chair, the violation is for allowing a non-accredited broadcaster to go on the air. That's the violation of the network.
Mm-mm.
The content is different.
So, okay, so yun po.
Yes.
Meron, are you, will you initiate po yung investigation or maybe a case against the network for allowing non-accredited broadcaster?
Considering the information gathered during this hearing, Your Honors, I will report this to the Standards Authority of KBP.
Yes, thank you po. Nakalagay po kasi dito, Mr. Chair, doon sa Broadcast Code of the Philippines 2007 and number 5B, section 5B, an unconfirmed report must be verified as soon as possible. If an unconfirmed report is found to be false, an announcement saying so must be made. So nakalagay po 'yun sa code. So ang meron pong responsibility and accountability dito ay yung network, kasi hindi naman accredited yung mga broadcasters, tama po?
As a rule, the content in any broadcast, as a rule, is the responsibility of the network.
So yan, iniimbestigahan na nga po ano kung ano yung nangyari. Okay. Sige, isa pang tanong. Doon po sa may ano no, doon po sa, so in the matter of being broadcast, for example po, if a matter of being broadcast is a threat or death threat, limbawa, ano po yung responsibility po doon ng network?
Mr. Chair, I'm sorry, I could not grasp the question. But if I, in the context of the subject matter of this hearing, I believe you're referring to the alleged death threat made by PRRD.
Yeah, so include that in the resolution, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Your Honor. Well, that's the responsibility of the guest. There should be a distinction between a live broadcast and a recorded broadcast.
Mm-hmm.
Mainly because in a live broadcast, you cannot stop the broadcast while it's being made. Whereas in a recorded broadcast, you have the opportunity to edit out the content before it is aired. So my understanding is the broadcast was live, and therefore the network's responsibility is mitigated by that fact. We have had cases in the KBP where the content in question was a live broadcast, and because it is live, the responsibility of the network was mitigated. Without saying, of course, that the broadcaster is not responsible.
The network is responsible? Are you saying that?
No. The responsibility of the network is mitigated by the fact that it is live.
Mm-hmm.
As distinguished from a material which is recorded, where the network had the opportunity to edit out the content or the content before being aired.
Okay. So may I ask the opinion of Attorney Domingo of the MAD as regards to the, how about yung pong mga about red tagging? Kasi alam ko po, meron kayong mga kaso ng mga red tagging. So may ask your opinion po about doon sa mga kaso niyo about red tagging.
Nakasala na po lahat yun. Naka-file na po lahat ng aming kaso on red tagging. Ibibigay ko po ng kopya ng ating mga complaints sa Madam Congressman. Karamihan po dito marami po dito, kasama po yung ating kasamahan dito. At pumunta po kami rin sa Professional Regulations Commission. At pinapaalis namin ang lisensya nung nasa sakdal. Pero yung pinaka relevant po dito sa ating pinag-usapan ngayon, yung pong kaso namin against Lorraine Marie Badoy Partosa sa NTC, no? At gusto namin paalisin din siya. Hindi pala, ngayon, nalaman po namin na hindi pala siya kasamang accredited ng broadcasters, no? So, hindi po namin alam kung pwede rin po namin bigyan siya ng accusation sa broadcaster's code violation. But ang isa pang question natin dito, sila Kibuloy ba? At saka si dating Presidente Duterte, accredited din buong broadcaster.
Ayan, darating po ako dyan. Darating po ako dyan, attorney, yung tanong na yan.
Pero yung po lahat na tinanong nyo po, marami po ito, no? Apat po kanina nasabi ko, at lima, pati kasama na po kay Atom Arroyo na aming na-file ng man, no? Against the two persons here in front of me. So, yung pong pinaka-latest. Of course, yung pong yung great threat na complaint na kami rin ng mahawak, nakabimbi na po yan sa Fiscal's Office ng Quezon City. At sa December 4 po, magkakaroon po ng preliminary investigation at December 11. So, okay. Continuing po itong aming advocacy at kami ay nakaakbang kami at kami willing to help the congressional committees to be able to craft the legislation in aid of legislation po itong ating hearing. We're willing to come up with our own position and we will provide the necessary papers for that, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, attorney. Balik po ako sa KBP. As regards po doon sa live or recorded, kasi sabi nyo, parang walang control po yung network kapag ito po ay live. Eh kung ito po ay in-upload sa mga Facebook, sa mga official Twitter or Facebook na network, kasi ang SMNI meron silang Facebook, meron silang Twitter, pero this yung content na yon ng merong laman ng grave threat ay nandoon pa rin. Even if itong dalawang broadcaster na to o yung black timer na ito ay hindi naman sila, I mean, siyempre hindi, sabi ng network, hindi nila control. Eh kung ito po ay yung threat na ito ay inakyat pa sa ano sa Facebook, in-upload pa. So ano po yung masasabi niyo doon, Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chair, can I dissect the question if you allow me?
Yeah, okay.
One is the responsibility of a guest in a program. The guest is not a broadcaster. He's not under the authority of the KBP, nor the network. So the guest can be liable for such things as libel, threat, etc., but not in the context of the code of KBP. If the person who makes the threat is an anchor, then the responsibility is the anchor's responsibility and possibly the network's for allowing it if it were recorded. Now, in the case of uploaded content, as distinguished from live streaming content, uploaded content is considered recorded material. And therefore, it is upon the person uploading to edit it in order to conform to community standards or the law, as the case may be. In streaming, live streaming, the control is limited because particularly the guest will answer. In the case of the alleged threat of the former president, the material is not content for which the network is responsible for, because that is what the anchor said. In fact, that is news as far as the network is concerned. As to the persons alluded to or against whom the threat was directed, that's a different matter. And that's between the guest for having aired the threat and the person being threatened.
So you are referring to the guest as the black timer in the case of yun nga yung nasa isang resolution dito in the case in this resolution, in this resolution po si President Duterte at saka si Kibuloy as black timer doon sa program na yon, nagikan sa masa para sa masa. So walang responsibility ang network. Kung merong pagmumura, kung merong threat o merong mga obscene na mga words, wala pong responsibility dahil sinasabi niyo po, hindi sila accredited broadcaster, hindi rin sila anchor. So, ano na lang po, kahit na sino lang po, pwedeng may gawin na doon. Basta may mababayaran lang po nila ang yung network. Pwede nang magmura. Pero yung sinasabi niyo yung code para sa mga broadcaster. So, ano naman po yung responsibility ng network doon? Doon sa mga black timer na mga nagmumura or nagsasalita ng hindi naman maganda or yun po, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, I don't know in what capacity the former president was airing in the station. In the context of the discussion, since that is a co-produced program, I doubt if the president was even a black timer there. Because that's a different arrangement.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, attorney. Tanong ko na lang sa SMNI. So, ano po yung laban, yung gikan sa masa para sa masa, ano po yung black timer po ba yun? Or...
Yes, Mr. Chair. It's yes. A black timer.
So, bumili sila ng oras.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So, black timer po. Attorney.
In a black time arrangement, basically, the network, the black timer is the party responsible for the content. The network, however, can post immediately after the fact, deal with the matter of the broadcast of the black timer. And in fact, if it is in violation of the code, it can be a ground for terminating the black time arrangement.
Okay. Thank you. Doon po na nalinawan ako doon.